With immigration reform coming into the spotlight now, let's take a look at the growing clout of the Hispanic vote in America. This will surely be part of the political calculus behind any bipartisan push, because Democrats won 7 in 10 Hispanic votes last time and may look to fulfill a promise to that voting bloc. But Republicans, many feel that they might use this to re-engage with the community that they lost overwhelmingly last time. So let's take a look, as a background, at just how the vote has been increasing and going overwhelmingly Democratic so far. In 2012, 7 in 10 Hispanic votes went for President Obama. And you can see on the chart that the number of Hispanic voters has been going up each successive election cycle. Now, in specific electoral terms, this could have been pivotal in a number of battleground states, Nevada, Colorado, even Florida. In all of them, President Obama's share of the vote, he got at least 1 in 5 votes from Hispanic voters, which was far greater than his overall statewide margin, again underscoring just how pivotal this voting bloc was. First, let's take a look at where the Hispanic population is concentrated today. It's largely in a range of states in the Southwest, going from California across to Texas, and notably in a couple of those battleground states that we mentioned, like Colorado and Nevada. But let's look into the future a little bit. If we look at the growth rate across the country, where the darkest areas reflect the fastest growing Hispanic population counties, we see that throughout the Midwest, down in the Southeast, down into Florida, we see very high rates of growth. What this means is that going forward, Hispanic clout will only increase as we look to other battleground states in the area, such as Virginia, North Carolina, even Iowa at some point perhaps down the road.